Hey everybody, my name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. I wanted to thank you for listening to this episode of The Morning Show. I'm the creator, the producer, and the host of the show. We want you to check out our website. It's themorningshowwithnatalie.com. You can go to that website. You can see all about our sponsors, all about the show. You can even listen to live episodes while they're going on right there from the website. Another way to listen to the show live is go to Live365. You can download that app and just search for The Morning Show. It's right there. Super easy. We want you to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel, if you will. That way you can keep up with what's going on The Morning Show. Thank you. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, friend. It's great to have you tuned into The Morning Show today. Here on The Morning Show, you'll hear your favorite Southern gospel music and some of the classics you'll never forget. And now, the hostess of The Morning Show, Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
When you wake up to the storm and all you feel are the waves crashing against your boat, you wonder if anybody remembers you or the journey that you're on. When you feel discouraged from what you see on the news or the events going on around you, well, friend, cut it off. Don't look to the left or to the right. Look up. And when everything inside of you is screaming to be afraid, to accept defeat, or to hand our enemy a victory, well, you need to sing. And then keep singing. Sing it some more. For we are God's people. And that's just what God's people do. Well, we sing.
You said sing from a laughing heart, to sing when the night is dark, to sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
God sent on flashing wings to fill the sky with song. Put music in the brook and crashing sea.
The wind blew through the threads of grass like fingers through the strings of golden harps that made the meadows sing.
Then he said, sing from a laughing heart, to sing when the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all.
Then he said, sing from a laughing heart, just sing when the night is dark, just sing. Let your joy explode and let music fill the air.
You can sing
when there's nothing else to do. Sing
called dibs on me, but he has been defeated. Once a victim, now a victor. You didn't know me when, but my story's been rewritten. Now my name is Victory.
Once upon a time, I was held captive. I had been a pawn in the devil's game. I was headed for death and destruction. Abuse, ashamed. A slave until the day Christ the Liberator broke those chains, gave me his power when I took his name. Born of the water, born of the spirit, born again, my name's been changed. My name is Victory. Once it was captivity, the enemy called dibs on me, but he has been defeated. Once a victim, now a victim. You didn't know me when,
but my story's been rewritten. Now my name is Victory.
Are you looking for hope and a future? Freedom from the lies of the enemy. He will try to taunt you with past failures, but the blood of Jesus has sealed his defeat.
God's power can set your spirit free. Who the sun sets free is free indeed. No longer slave, you've been adopted in his name, so you can say, my name is Victory. Once it was captivity, the enemy called dibs on me, but he has been defeated. Once a victim, now a victim.
My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. You are listening to The Morning Show. Starting out with a praise note this morning, a new report has been released by the Christian Post that says many churches across the United States saw bountiful crowds on Easter Sundays, and many broke records like they have never seen before. This is quite significant because since the COVID-19 pandemic began in March of 2020, church services this well attended have been rare. Many churches have struggled to get in-house attendance back alive again. But this Easter Sunday, people seem to come back. Many came back that haven't been in a very long time. Churches in the Northeast even reported a struggle to find room to put all those in attendance. Many churches across the nation had standing room only for Easter, and we have not seen that in quite some time. So we are giving God all the praise and glory for that. I believe this is a sign of God's Spirit stirring across the country and inviting those who have neglected to listen for a long time. We are thankful.
I see it. cause everybody cares. I see churches so filled up on Sundays, they're bringing in folding chairs. I see a crowd by the river, every color, every age. They're going down sinners and coming up saints. I see revival.
Thursday, we do have a guest, my sister Nicole Smith. She will be here on the morning show, second hour, shortly after 7 o'clock a.m. Central Time. She'll be right here to share some adventures she's recently been on. She's going to tell you all about it, and I can't wait for her to get here. It's going to be a fantastic day. I'm excited about Nicole coming, and I'm glad you're here to be with us. Hey, don't forget, the YouTube episodes will be a little late this week. We normally have them up about lunchtime every day, but they will be delayed this week. It'll be Monday of next week before most of this week's episodes are loaded on the YouTube channel. So we want to give you a heads up about that. We want you to know there'll be a slight delay this week, but they're coming. Just be a few days.
Ever ponder your problems? Wonder about worries? Consider circumstances growing out of control. Do you debate your dilemmas? Speculate on the outcomes? It can sure weigh heavy on your soul. But if you'll think about no more fears in a land where tears are forever wiped away, if you'll think about going home and the joy you'll know seeing Jesus face to face, your fear of the future fades when you're sure there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here, though trouble's coming near. If you'll think about that. On the new song, rising out of heaven and
rides and a bogging down in humdrum. Chart a course for the kingdom. It'll do you so much good to think about there. Cause if you'll think about
no more fears in a land where tears are forever wiped away. If you'll think about going home and the joy you'll know seeing Jesus face to face. Your fear of the future fades when you're sure there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here, though trouble's coming near. If you think about there.
So friend, keep looking up. Set your mind on things above. If you'll think about no more fears in a land where tears are forever.
Sure, there's a hope beyond compare. It'll really help you live down here, though trouble's coming near.
It'll really help you live down here, though trouble's coming near.
If you'll think about hey.
Brand new one from the most awarded trio in the history of Southern gospel music, Greater Vision, entitled Think About There. Michaela Brown of the Browns has a few words to say about their latest release. It's called Breakthrough.
There is a line in this song in the chorus that says, you're not alone in this, he's on your side. And I love that message. I love the picture that it represents, that whatever you're going through, the difficult times in your life, that you are not alone in it, that you can take those situations, bring them to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and he will lead you to...
Jesus wasn't worried. Lazarus' funeral passed, but he stayed home. All the family spoke with doubt, but then death began to shout. Here comes the rock that rolls away the stone. When the rock says roll, it's gotta move. Those great clothes on the floor are giving proof. Just take back all your flowers in resurrection power. God's about to send the mourners home. Here comes the rock that rolls away the stone. When hope has long been carried to the grave where it's been buried, and all that you can do is sit and moan. In the shadows of your heart, you'll hear sandals in the dark. Cause here comes the rock that rolls away the stone. Yeah, when the rock says roll, it's gotta move. Those great coals on the floor are living proof. Just take back all your flowers in resurrection power. God's about to send the mourners home. Cause here comes a rock that rolls away the stone. There's no way to stop him. Death is not a friend of his. The tomb will soon be empty. Cause life is who he is. Yeah, when the rock says roll, it's gotta move, gotta move, gotta move. Those great clothes on the floor are living through. Yeah, when the rock says roll, it's gotta move. Those great clothes on the floor are living through. Just take back all your flowers in resurrection power. God's about to send the mourners home. Cause here comes the rock that rolls away the stone.
Hey everybody, This is Southbound, and you're listening to The Morning Show with Natalie.
Life of mine, stumbled, fell a million times, too many regrets to try and count. I've shattered dreams and broken hearts, wounded some that's left them scarred. In spite of that, I always seem to find waiting there for all.
Your faithfulness has never failed. Your compassion's beyond compare. Your forgiveness keeps amazing me.
Music, ministry, and more. It's The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons.
You're listening to The Morning Show. And now, with your patriotic point of view, here's Larry Gresset.
Messiah is an English language oratorio composed in 1741 by George Frederick Handel. The text was compiled from the King James Bible and the Coverdale Psalter. It was first performed in Dublin on this day in history, April the 13th, 1742, and received its London premiere nearly a year later. The oratorio eventually became one of the best-known and most frequently performed choral works in Western music. Handel composed The Messiah in just 24 days. For a work of this magnitude to be written so quickly is an amazing accomplishment. One might even speak of divine inspiration, for Handel once declared, "When I composed the Hallelujah Chorus, I did think I saw all heaven before me and the great God himself." The resounding success of Messiah and other Handel works in Dublin during 1741 and 1742 virtually launched a new career for the composer, though it also had its difficulties. A London premiere of Messiah in 1743 had to be billed simply as a new sacred oratorio, since its title might be offensive to the legalistic purified congregation. Messiah was actually a failure at first and only began to gain success in 1750 when Handel conducted it for charity. Messiah, however, more than any other oratorio, set the path for Handel's reemergence as a composer in England and eventually turned out to be the flight of a rocket to the stars for Handel's future position in music and in the hearts of his listeners. I'm Larry Gresset with your patriotic point of view.
The Patriotic Point of View was brought to you by Joe McGee Construction. Joe McGee Construction believes family is one of God's greatest gifts. Family owned and operated for the past 33 years, Joe McGee Construction is the proud employer of some of Mississippi's best tradesmen. Together, we are supporting our communities and working hard to ensure that every commute to work and every ride to school brings us safely home to our loved ones. Valuing faith, family, and the Magnolia State, Joe McGee Construction is building safer roads for a better Mississippi. Joe McGee is my friend, and I thank him for helping us bring you the best mix of Southern gospel music, along with your patriotic point of view here on The Morning Show.
The king told Daniel not to pray to his God anymore. I'll lock you in the lion's den and throw away the key to the door. But the very next day found Daniel down on his bended knee. The difference this time, he opened the blind so the whole wide world could see. I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. Gonna lift my hands unto the Lord for the things he's done for me. Find a place to seek his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray. They tell our children not to pray when they walk through the schoolhouse door. According to the Constitution, you can't do that anymore. I wonder just what old Daniel would say if he were alive today. If the judge declared would say, I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. Gonna lift my hands unto the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just got to get away, I'll find a place to seek his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray. We'll be right back.
One of these days I'm going home where no sorrows ever come. We'll soon be done with troubles and trials, free from heartache, pain, and care. We shall all that glory share. Sit down beside my Jesus. Sit down and rest a little while.
We'll soon be done.
We'll soon be done with troubles and trials
in my little home.
In that home on the other side. I'm gonna shake glad hands with the elders. Tell my kindred good morning.
I'm gonna
sit down beside my Jesus.
Yes, I'm gonna
sit down and rest a little while. I shall behold his blessed face. I shall feel his matchless grace.
We'll soon be done
with troubles and trials. Oh, what peace and joy sublime in that home of love divine. Sit down beside my Jesus.
Yes, I'm gonna
sit down and rest a little while.
We'll soon be done.
We'll soon be done with troubles and trials.
Troubles and trials in my little home.
In that home on the other side. I'm gonna shake glad hands with the elders. Tell my kindred good morning.
I'm gonna
sit down beside my Jesus.
Yes, I'm gonna
sit down and rest a little while.
We'll soon be done.
We'll soon be done with troubles and trials.
Troubles and trials in my little home.
In that home on the other side. I'm gonna shake glad hands with the elders. Tell my kindred good morning.
I'm gonna
sit down beside my Jesus.
Yes, I'm gonna
sit down and rest a little while.
I'm gonna
sit down beside my Jesus.
Lord, I'm gonna
sit down and rest a little while.
Bluegrass group called Iliard Time Out. I really like them, and you know that old hymn, "We'll Soon Be Done with Troubles and Trials." Our featured artist of the week is the Henson family. That's Weston and Christy Henson. They have a brand new CD out. It's called Sundays Never End. Weston will be here tomorrow to talk about this incredible album. I want to play the title track today. I'm pretty impressed with the writers. You're going to know one of them, our friend Jason Davidson from right in Sebastopol, Mississippi. He helped to write this song. I want you to hear it. Here's the Henson family.
We heard the preacher preach, and we heard the choir sing, "Sweet victory in Jesus and amazing grace." And we'd go to Grandma's house. She'd bring the dinner out, and she made sure we had enough to fill our plates. Then we'd bow our heads and we say grace. And we all gather at her table, trading stories, and talk about the life that we live, and celebrate the hope we have in glory, and thank the Lord for moments just like this. And then next week we do it all again, 'cause Sundays never end. I can see her at the stove, mashing taters and bacon rolls, with all us little children running round. With a smile upon her face, she'd give us all a little taste and show us what it meant to love out loud. Then we'd bow our heads,
grace, and we all gather at her table, trading stories and talk about the life that we live and celebrate the hope we have in glory and thank the Lord for moments just like this. And then next week we do it all again, 'cause Sundays never end. Now we all got the news, and it always comes too soon. But ain't it just like life for that to happen? Broke my heart when Grandma left. There's so much I won't forget. And I hope she's proud and looking down from heaven as we bow our heads. Oh, and we say grace, and we all gather at her table, trading stories about the life that she lived and celebrate the hope we have in glory and thank the Lord for moments just like this, 'cause one day we'll be with her again where Sundays never.
Everyone, this is Randy, your morning show announcer, taking time to tell you about Lang's Locksmith from right here in Lake Mississippi. Lang's Locksmith is locally owned and operated by Kenny Lang and offers services for all of your residential, commercial, and church facilities. He offers master keying, rekeying, lock replacement, padlocks keyed to your existing home, business, or church key, master brand padlocks keyed to your existing master padlock key. Locked out of your home, automobile, or business? No big deal. Just call our friends at Lang's Locksmith at 601-906-7764. That's 601-906-7764. Give them a call, leave a message, and Kenny Lang or someone from his staff will get back with you just as soon as they can. Hey, thanks again for supporting Miss Natalie and the Morning Show right here on Live 365. And as always, may the Lord richly bless you.
In celebration of the Jordan Family Band's new single, Jesus and Me, SouthernGospelPrizes.com is giving away 5 Jesus and Me t-shirts. Register to win at SouthernGospelPrizes.com. We'll draw the winners May 7th. Be sure to listen for this new song from the Jordan Family Band and register to win your own Jesus and Me t-shirt. Southern Gospel Prizes for Southern Gospel fans. SouthernGospelPrizes.com.
Rejoicing through the sun, friend, and land, glory land is waiting all the way.
Satan's big scheme just might have worked, but there was one thing he overlooked. Some little saint had listened to God and got on their knees. And somebody glory to God, they prayed me out of harm's way. Some spirit-filled child has touched the Lord for me today. The Father just told them of my need, and they prayed me out of Satan's reach. Rejoicing in victory, they prayed me out of harm's way.
Absolutely love to hear from Emily Ann Roberts. And here she is talking about, well, sometimes she gets a mixed up kind of crowd.
I have had, and you know this, we have had people come to events who have said, I thought I was coming to a country show.
Yeah.
And I love that. I mean, I love it. And you know, I sing gospel shows, I sing country shows, and I'm just thankful that God has given me these platforms, and it's amazing how he uses them both. It's just been incredible, and it's a testimony that if you commit your ways to the Lord and you seek him, he will use you. It doesn't matter if you're working at the checkout line at Kroger, or if you're a pastor, or if you're a Sunday school teacher, or if you're painting people's fingernails. I mean, God uses each and every person exactly where he has them.
I can't help but wonder if these floorboards creaked the same in 42 when my great-grandpa poured his heart and soul into preaching the good news. And these tattered old red hymn books have caught a tear or two, 'cause it's hard to sing just as I am without the Spirit moving you. If those altars at the front could testify, I know they'd say it never once got old hearing a sinner call his name. I know the stained glass never saved a soul, and these pews ain't on the roll that's come up yonder. I know the pulpit's just a wood awe and wonder. I know it's just a building, plain and simple white, but it's the building where Jesus changed my life. I never claimed to be the biggest, nobody ever called it cool, but it's where my mama met my daddy at vacation Bible school. It's been the picture perfect dream of a thousand glowing brides. It's heard the weeping as a loved one's laid to rest with sad goodbyes. And I know the stained glass never saved a soul, and these pews ain't on the roll. It's cold up yonder. I know stand here forever, but I'll sure miss it when it's gone, and I'll be forever grateful to call that church my home. I know the stained glass never saved a soul, and these pews ain't on the road.
Natalie Duncan-Emmons. Stay tuned. The best is yet to come.
You're listening to The Morning Show. And now it's time for your pastor's perspective. Brought to you this morning by Brother Tal Vardaman of Lime Creek Baptist Church, Morton, Mississippi.
God loves you and you can trust Him. No matter how it turns out, you can trust His power. There's a power that the Word of God tells us about. Over in the New Testament in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, this power is at the top of an old hill called Golgotha, at the top of Mount Calvary outside of Jerusalem. A man was nailed to a crucifix, a cross, and that cross was raised so that the whole world could see that this man died, this man Jesus. And the Bible claims that Jesus was the Son of God. Can you believe that? It says that He lived a sin-free life so that He could sacrifice Himself for you and me. Can you believe that? And the Bible says that they didn't take Jesus' life, but that He gave it freely on the cross of Calvary. Can you believe that? 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 18 says, "For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God." And today, if you can't believe that, then it might sound pretty silly to you. It might appear foolish that a man claiming to be the Son of God would give his life on a torture rack to pay the cost of your sins. It might sound foolish to you, but try this on. It's been just under 2,000 years since Jesus gave his life on the cross of Calvary, and people are still being saved today. Men and women and children are still being set free from their sin. It might sound foolish to you, but to those of us who have been saved by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, it is not foolishness, but it is the majestic and wonderful power of God. This is Brother Tal Vardaman, and this has been your Pastor Perspective.
The Pastor's Perspective was brought to you by Salem Baptist Church in Lake, Mississippi. Salem is my home church, and I'm thrilled that they've partnered with The Morning Show to help us bring you, well, not only the best music in the world, but encouragement and words of life straight from God's Word. Brother Larry Duncan and the entire congregation at Salem, they invite you to come and visit whenever you get the chance. We're located just a few miles off of I-20 coming through mid-Mississippi. So if you live in our area, if you're ever traveling through our area on a Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, well, you stop off the lake exit and visit with us. Thank you to Salem Baptist Church for bringing you your pastor's perspective.
Myself to blame. I pray, Jesus, please deliver me in your holy name. Broken chains on the ground, free at last, and now I'm glory bound. I'm no longer shackled to the misery and shame. Everywhere I look, there's broken chains, broken chains. Every day, but now I have the power to turn and walk the other way. God's light is there to guide me, it helps me not to stray. And in my hour of victory, I give him all the praise. Broken chains on the ground, free at last, and now I'm glory bound. I'm no longer shackled to the misery and shame.
Throwback Thursday mode right now, so we're throwing it back to the Kingdom Heirs. Right after this, my sister Nicole, she's going to be right here on The Morning Show. You can't miss Nicole. Here's the Kingdom Heirs.
If I'm blind to his will for me, then I'll wait to be shown. And like Paul, I'll have an answer to at the end of Damascus Road.
Master Tech.
is Natalie Duncan-Emmons. You're listening to The Morning Show, and I've got a treat for you today. We've got my sister, Nicole Smith. She is back right here on The Morning Show. I told you yesterday, I said I hadn't asked her yet, but I'm going to ask her to come say a few words, and she has agreed. Welcome back to The Morning Show, Nicole.
Glad to be back, she asked, and I said, well, of course, and I'm back.
Nicole, did you hear me say that on the show yesterday?
I heard you say that on the show. I said, well, Lord, let me get my shoes on.
Let me get out there as quick as I can.
Let me get her on the telephone.
Well, there's no better way to put a fella on the spot than to just ask him on the air like that.
Well, yeah, you did put a, but you know, I don't usually don't mind being put on the spot. I do what I can when I can.
Well, you've been a little down and out over the past year, off and on, but it's looking a little better.
I've had some better weeks. I've had about 5 good weeks in a row. I'll take it. I'll take it.
Well, look, we don't really have anything in particular so much that we're talking about today, but it is Throwback Thursday, and we don't have a guest. You're it. You are our throwback. Is there anything you are wanting to throw it back to?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to throw it back. I'm going to throw it back about as far as you've ever thrown it back. Guess where I went?
Where'd you go?
I went to the Ark.
Nicole, I want
to
hear all about that. I've been saying I'm going
to
go.
Yeah, you can't throw back much further than Genesis. Now, I didn't travel in time, but I went to Kentucky.
You're right, Nicole.
Yeah, we throw it way
Noah's
back.
Noah's about as far
Noah's,
back as you can
You
go.
Can't go much further. I went to Kentucky, and I went and saw the Ark. You know, they rebuilt that thing and opened it in 2016, and I'd never had the opportunity to go. And Jason and I took his parents, my mother-in-law and father-in-law, Mr. J.D. and Miss Lizzie, and we loaded up, and we drove up there. And I'm telling you something, it was wonderful.
About how long did it take you to drive up there?
Well, we cut that thing in half because I had a little doctor's appointment, so we did it in 2 days. I think the total would have put us about 9.5, something like that, I think. We broke it down. And maybe a little bit farther. Jason would know.
Well, I want to hear all about it. I truly have wanted to go. I'm going to go later on this summer. I'm going to take Tate. I'm going to make sure I go. He's got an event in Kentucky, so we're going to do it all when we go. But, Nicole, I want the details now. What did it look like? How'd you feel when he got there? Tell me all about this Ark.
Oh, it's worth the drive. It's worth the drive. I don't think I could have ever, in my wildest imagination, really comprehended how large that thing was. You know, they built that thing to scale. God give Noah the exact measurements for the length, the width, the height, all this
kind of
stuff.
And we know that from the Bible.
We got that. That's as factual as you can get. And they built it to scale. And I'm telling you, that thing's massive. It is massive. And I don't think you really understand it until you're standing there beside it. And you go, wow.
We can't comprehend it.
Wow. And I know a lot of things when you get into the Ark, you know, they had to speculate because we don't have every detail about the interior of it. We don't. But a lot of what we do have, they just did an excellent job of staying true to that size and putting that up there. I'm going to tell you something else. It was a kind of a breathtaking moment to me to be standing there by that huge thing and walk up that plank and know you're going in that thing. And in my mind, in my heart, I was just kind of talking to the Lord that day when we first got to walk in. And I was like, wow, Lord. He said, yeah, this is going to wow you. And I walked up that plank, and I'm just thinking what Noah and his family felt like that day. Mm-hmm. Unbelievable. You just got to go. You got to walk in that thing and experience that. I'd recommend anybody. Get in your car, get in your plane, do something. Ride a donkey. Just get up there.
Jump on your plane. Well, listen, talking about speculation, this is the way I believe about that kind of thing. I believe if the Lord called you to build that ark, if he give you the means, if he give you the calling, if he give you the desire to do something like that, I believe he's going to lay it on your heart what to do when you build it. He said, well, you didn't know exactly what the inside was like. You didn't know what this was like. I believe he's going to give you exactly the insight that you need to get it pretty close.
Yeah, get it pretty close and make a picture for people to see. You know, and I've thought about this, and Natalie, I've pondered it. I stood back on that parking lot and I looked at that thing. And we look at the world around us today. Now, as Christians, we know in the Old Testament, we know the story of Noah and the ark. We know that that ark was built and created as a means of salvation for those who would believe and get on it because judgment was coming. And you look at our world today and the shape we're in and where we're at, and you and I know it's heavy on our hearts that the return of the Lord is something that's near. We're closer than we've ever been to the Lord calling his church home. And isn't that just like the Lord?
Just like.
It's just like the heart of our Father just to say, it's getting close. Build it again.
Yeah, do it again.
Build it again. Build it and put it on a hill in Kentucky. You know, they're coming from all over the world to tour that thing and look at that thing. And it is, and they did. I'm going to tell you something. Dr. Ken Ham, all those people who are, you know, the originators, the CEOs of all that, they did a tremendous job of presenting the gospel. Not only did they want you to tour the ark and go through factual stuff and, you know, all that science stuff and, you know, all of that part of geology and everything and the flood, they did great with that. But their star moment was when they sit down with you and they show a film or they have somebody talk to you about, hey, this ark was provided for salvation. We live in a day where God's fixing to judge this earth. Where's your trust? Where's your hope? You need an ark, and that ark is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. And they didn't cut any corners there. And in my heart, I'm glad that people know things now that go there about the flood, about Genesis. That's wonderful. I wish we all knew more. But what touched my heart more than anything is in these last days, God built an ark again and said, hey, there's salvation for all who will believe.
And you said they're coming from everywhere. You saw that with your own eyes, right?
Oh, yeah, there's some folks there who spoke a language you didn't even know. I don't even know where they were from.
Kind of like going to Disney World. You hear all kind of stuff.
Yeah, you did. There were people, and they said they're coming from all over the globe to see it, to the hills of Kentucky. Isn't that something?
And of all places, Kentucky.
On a hill in Kentucky, the Lord told them, rebuild it. And there she sits.
There's some beauty in that.
There's some beauty in it.
Well, there's only one song appropriate to follow this up with, and you can probably guess what it is.
Well, I've got a hunch, but I hope it's a good one. If it ain't that one, I hope it's another good one.
It's going to be a good one. Here we go. We're going to go back and play the Gaithers. This one is not so much a throwback. It's only a few years old, but it's a great song. It's called Build an Ark. We've been talking about that ark. Nicole went and saw it. Saw it with her own eyes. I know many of you have. I have not.
But we're going to remedy that.
I'm going. But when we come back after the song, I wanted to tell you about one more thing. So don't go anywhere. We're coming right back with Nicole Smith on The Morning Show.
And my brother, was to love each other.
Build an ark, head for the open water. Save your sons and your daughters. Build an ark. Build an ark. When the storm has ended, you know the world has been mended.
On the morning show with my sister Nicole. She is freshly home from a big trip to Kentucky on the art. Now, Nicole, you've been a little down and out in your health. How did you hold out for such a trip as this?
Well, I'm gonna tell you like this. I know Brother Noah
she knows.
Was give out after he spent all them, I forgot how long, how many years. I think it's 75 years. Don't hold me to that. I don't know. It was, I forgot. I did know, but I forgot. I know he was give out when he got through building that thing.
Exhausted.
He's exhausted, but he wasn't half as tired as I am. I'm just about
He might not have been as sick as you be.
I'm telling you, he was in better shape than me to build that thing. But I'm telling you what, I did it, and I am so thankful. I asked the Lord to let my body hold up to do that because I didn't want to be a burden on the trip. You know, I didn't want to be, I wanted to do good so bad. And he did. And I am about wore out, though. I am.
But you survived it.
I survived. I saw, as my daddy used to say, I saw the high diving act. That's what my daddy would have said.
Did you learn anything you didn't know?
I learned that most dinosaurs was only about waist high. I mean, there was some big ones. Don't get me wrong. There's some you didn't want to mess with. But according to Dr. Ken, most dinosaurs, most of them wasn't but about a, you know, waist high. A lot of little small, a lot of little small dinosaurs.
I don't really understand anything about dinosaurs. I know they say they existed. I believe they existed. They find the bones all the time. I don't know anything about dinosaurs. I've heard some people say that in the flood is when we lost the dinosaurs, but they say that the dinosaurs did get on the ark. Is that what they believe?
Some say there was some juvenile small ones. I know one thing about dinosaurs. I don't want to mess with none of them. I don't care if they little dinosaurs, big dinosaurs. They just make me nervous, a dinosaur, just the sound of it. But I did learn this. Did you know you won't ever find the word dinosaur in the Bible?
Mm-mm.
You know why?
Why?
Didn't even come up with that word 1841.
Well, there's that. There's that.
You got to look for descriptions. They said Job described two of them in Job.
What is that?
Well, I don't recollect. I'd have to go look it up. But I read it.
I didn't take notes.
I read it in the museum. I read it. In the, see, we went to the Ark, and then we went to the Creation Museum. But they said there, now Job would have never said, look there, it's a dinosaur. Because mm-hmm. that word didn't even exist. But they said that.
A great creature or something
yes,
like that.
Yes, he described two great creatures in the book of Job. And they said that that's what he was describing was one. Now, I don't know because I've not talked to Job, just like I've not talked to Noah. But
don't text us debating dinosaurs because we are not taking a stance one way or another.
Oh, no.
That's just what she heard. We don't know.
I'm just telling you what I saw at the high diving act. I'm just telling you what I saw.
What they say.
And but I don't want to mess with a dinosaur. They said there's little dinosaurs and there's medium dinosaurs.
I just don't want to mess with a dinosaur.
Well, we don't have any anymore.
So no, we don't have to worry about it. I mean, you know, I was attacked by a dog one time, and I sure don't want to mess with a dinosaur.
That's all we can handle is a German Shepherd.
I don't believe I've ever even told him about that, about getting attacked. And I won't tell it today.
We did tell about you getting dog bit.
Do they know that?
She's had a long trip.
I told you, me and Noah are exhausted.
We told all about you getting dog bit.
That's right,
you
don't believe it. I believe I did tell it. I'm tired now. My brain's tired.
Because I don't believe I ever told him about that.
I guess I did.
When the Lord saved.
I want to ask you about this. I've heard that there is a good group up there, Dusty Wells over at Daywind. I went and visited over there. He told me that they were fixing to sign a group up there at the Ark that sang there all the time. Did you hear a group that sang?
Oh, my soul, yes. I heard them sing. I heard them sing at the Ark. Well, the next day, we went to the Creation Museum, and I listened to them there because they sing at both attractions. Mm-hmm. These are sister attractions. Those guys did a wonderful job. They're called True Song. And they just did a tremendous... I was just very impressed with them. Of course, I knew two of the guys. When I didn't realize it till I got there. But two of the gentlemen, Dusty and Michael, have been to Salem before with another group when they used to be with Sold Out. And Dusty is one of my favorite tenors in gospel music. So I was just elated to see
Dusty
him.
Barrett.
I love him to death. He's just precious. And little Michael's just precious. And they just did a wonderful job. I got to meet the other two guys, did a tremendous job. Matter of fact, they told me they're having a big celebration party, like a release party for their new CD sometime in May. Now, they said they was going to tell you to come.
They've already invited me. Already sent me an email and said they wanted me and Tate to come, and I'm going to take you too.
Yeah, well, I've wanted to be sure that part got told because they told me.
That's why she brought up the release party.
They told me. They said, no, we're having a release party. And they said, we're going to invite Natty. And said, now, if Natty comes, we want you to come too. Now, I don't know if this will happen or this won't happen. But now, Dusty told me that the release party, we had to go to a separate building for the concert. But at the release party, they're going to sing on the Ark.
The big stage. That's what he told me, too. He said Tate and I were going to be special guests at the event.
And me. He said for me to come.
And Dico.
Yeah. And I'm special. I'm special, and I'm tired, so I sure need to be recognized. Well, if I can make that trip again.
I'm going to take her back. We're going to go to that release party whenever it comes out.
Now, when is that release party?
Dusty told me the official date had not been set, looking like going to be the end of May. But he said he would let me know immediately when they set the date.
He needs to let us know. I got a lot going on in May.
May's just about filled up.
May has got some slim pickings in it for Dusty.
Well, actually, our calendar is getting pretty full.
But I want to go. I want to go support her.
Nicole said she'd cancel something if she had to.
I have to. Mind.
Well, I told him, let us know. We would do our best. That would be a great honor to get to go and be a part of that. And I was tickled about that.
Well, and if you take me, since I have been, I'll show you how to get in the Ark. I know right where the entrance is, where you go up the ramp.
Well, that settles that. We're for sure taking Deco. Well, look, I'm glad to hear all of this about the Ark. That's a really good update and review that you've mm-hmm. given us about the trip. Mm-hmm. I'm tickled about it. I'm glad you got to go, and it makes me excited for when I get to go. I want to encourage everybody to go out there. They have some good singing, a lot of good information. Do they have a preacher that preaches?
No, but they do have videos that give the plan of salvation. Like I said, and they talk about the first Adam and the second Adam and all that. So it's not necessarily a preacher as such, but there's a lot of videos and a lot of things that's just very interesting. It just make you think.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what you are, a deep thinker.
I'll tell you, if it did anything for me, it added to my question list of things I want to ask the Lord when we get there. You know, the Bible that we have covers thousands and thousands of years, and that's so few words to cover such a vast amount of time. So God gives us the information that we need to know that leads us to Jesus. Mm-hmm. But all the details and little things, it'll just make you so curious. You just want to know. And when I get to heaven, I got a lot more questions now.
We're going to ask him. Nicole, is there anything you want to go, any song you want to go out with this morning, considering it's Throwback Thursday?
Hey, I tell you what, since we're talking about the Ark, the first Adam, the second Adam, and the Ark that God's provided for us, play that song by the Steels. God has provided a lamb.
That's a good one. Jeff Steele is our friend, been our friend a long time. This goes back, I don't know, about, could be 20 years.
I don't know. I don't know. It fits, though. I'm thankful for the Lamb of God. I'm thankful for the Ark of my salvation through His Son, Jesus Christ. Play that.
to bless my heart today.
All right, Nicole, we appreciate you being on the morning show, giving us this good update. We'll have you back real soon.
And I'm going to come back.
Yeah, you can come back and tell about that release party we're going to go to.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to try to do. I'm going to try to go to that.
Yeah, we will. All right, here's the Steals. I actually think the name of it is God Kept His Promise. It's the same thing. Here's the Steals.
God spoke to Abraham, here is your desire. You and your wife Sarah are going to have a child. Abraham responded, we are old, how can this be? And God said, I promise you and Sarah, just believe. And God kept His promise, He honored His word. The womb that was empty has now been. Was dying on an old rugged tree. When he cried, it is finished, they took his body down. And God's redemption promise was laid in the on the first day of the week, came Mary bearing spices, his body to keep. When she arrived at the tomb, two men in white were there to say that God kept His promise.
Here to let the world know God's got a song, and it is the song of salvation through Jesus Christ and Him alone. And we will sing this song and we will play this song as long as we have breath in these bodies. And then the Lord will give us a new song, a song that only the redeemed can sing, and we will sing that song through all of eternity. My name is Natalie Duncan-Emmons, and you are listening to The Morning Show.
My sins away. My sins away.
featured artist of the week all week long has been the Henson family. Tomorrow, Weston Henson is going to be here to talk about this project. So we have one last chance before Weston gets here tomorrow to highlight this album. We're going to do that this morning. We're fixing to do a double take, two in a row of songs off of this project. You need to order this. You need to go to the Henson family website and get this album, Sundays Never End. It'll be worth your while and your money. Here's the first one on the album, Staying With Him. Here's the Henson family.
I've been tempted to run and give up the fight. Head for what's wrong while forsaking what's right. But then I recall all the victories behind. He delivered me when there was no way to win. So I've made up my mind, and I'm staying with him, 'cause he's standing with me. And wherever he is, that's right where I'm. Had a wife, she said, don't even try. God messed up your life, and she said, just curse him and die. But old Joe wouldn't quit, though he had been crushed. From the ashes that they heard him shout out these words, and God, I still trust, and I'm staying with him, 'cause he's standing with me, and wherever he is, that's right where I'm.
If you're just tuning in, you're in the middle of a double take from our featured artist, the Henson family, off of their brand new project, Sundays Never End. This one is called Condemned.
Sitting worn out and hollow, dead at the end, a lonely structure lost between what was and could have been. You can see all the damage caused by the storms and wind. Boarded up, locked down, empty and condemned. Now you may think I'm talking about a lonely vacant home, but the truth is, I'm talking about a tattered, wounded soul. But a carpenter saw value and restored my life with hope. Now I'm no longer locked down, empty and condemned. On him I'm standing strong, because of sweet redemption, all the old
it's only because of what he did. Never will I ever be again. Come down. Oh, now I have a firm foundation. On him I'm standing strong. All the old is gone, and it's only because of what he did. Never will I ever be again. Come down. And it's only because of what
to you about the good folks over at Hometown Roots in Sebastopol, Mississippi. Hey, it's graduation. I know you're getting graduation invitations in the mail. If you haven't yet, you will be in just the next few weeks. I want you to think about Hometown Roots for all of your graduation needs. They have the absolute greatest graduation gifts that you will find right there at Hometown Roots. They have wallets. They have ID holders. That's what people use nowadays, the young people. They just use ID holders. They have the cash and card wallet holders. They have all of those things that you know they're going to need when they go off to college. They have personal gifts that you can give for graduation. For girls or guys, either one, they have loaded down gifts for graduation. I'm encouraging you to use Hometown Roots. They help support us right here on the morning show every single day. So if you don't know what to get them, just get them a gift card for Hometown Roots. That's what I intend to do this year for my graduates. Call Kitty Ladner, 601-625-7512. That's just the place to be for all your graduation.
If I'm only here to tell you one story, it's that God can work anything for good. The way that he writes it is glory to glory, page for page, no matter how it looks. If you need a highway through the sea, your mountain to be moved, he did it for me. He can do it for me.
for me is gonna do it for you.
I remember many nights when I felt so alone, needing just to talk to someone on the telephone.
Wraps up another fun day on the morning show. It's always fun when Nicole comes and visits on the show. Don't forget tomorrow, Weston Henson is going to be spending some time on the morning show. Wrapping up with the inspirations from Bryson City, North Carolina. Have a good day.
From the dawning of creation, all the saint of every nation who have lived on this earth and are gone shall awaken from their slumber, rise to join that countless number on that great resurrection morn.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise. Glory light will our brows adore.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise on that great resurrection morn. Those who've left us vacant places will be there with smiling faces, and our hearts there again will be torn. That will be a happy meeting. All our loved ones will be greeting on that great resurrection morn.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise. Glory light will our brows adore.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise on that great resurrection morn.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise. Glory light will our brows adore.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise.
We shall rise
on that great resurrection.
Great resurrection.
Resurrection morn.
Resurrection morn.
You've been listening to The Morning Show with Natalie Duncan-Emmons. We're glad you joined us. We want to invite you back tomorrow when once again you'll hear some of the very best in gospel music and some of the finest in Christian entertainment. Will you join us tomorrow? Is it a date? We'll look for you then. God bless and goodbye, everybody.